8:14 is your time, and new this morning, some of the best college track and field athletes are in Northern California right now.
And it is all for the NCAA Division II Track and Field Championships taking place at CSU Stanislaus, and KCRA 3's Mae Fesai is live in Tulock now with a preview of that big event.
Good morning, ladies. Yes, more than 1,000 participants are here right now at CSUS. Check out the morning warm-ups going on right now. We're talking about athletes from all over the nation coming right here to our home turf. And this is all brand new here at Al Brenda Track at Warrior Stadium. Just a couple of years new, and they really get to compete this morning throughout the weekend on some first-class terrain. With us this morning is Kim Deist, CSUS Associate Athletics Director. Thanks so much for being here. You guys got the bid in February of 2010. Ever since then, it's been go, go, go to get ready.
Yes, it has. It's been really exciting. I also chair the NCAA Track and Field Committee, and we were real excited when we got the bid. So once that happened, Milt Richards, our athletic director, we formed a local organizing committee with the city of Tulock and the campus here at CSU Stanislaus, and everyone has just embraced this championships, and we've worked every day,
yeah.
For over a year, but it's all going to be worth it because it's just a gorgeous facility.
And tell me what it means for these athletes from across the nation to be able to come here and compete on this kind of terrain, on this type of facility.
Athletes like to come and compete on a quality facility.
Sure.
When we built this facility, we were hoping that we could host a national championship, and there's a lot of people can watch. It's
yeah.
great views, and you know they like to be in the spotlight. They
Very
like
good.
To feel embraced, and I
good.
Think this facility will do that for them.
Okay, let's bring in one of those athletes right now, one of our very own. This is Alicia Wagner, women's pole vault. Alicia, you've been all over the country competing. You were just in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Now you get to be on your own home turf. How does that change things for you?
It makes things, puts it obviously in perspective, but it's also great that my teammates themselves also get to see what a great thing that I've been doing over the country for the past 2 years. So
sure.
it's a very, very fun experience, and I'm very grateful that, you know, Kim and some other people on our track team and committee basically got this here for us. It's a great thing.
And grateful to have such nice weather
yeah.
compared to what you've been competing in across the country as well.
Yeah, I'm used to rain and thunder and lightning and all that good stuff, you know, postponing events and kind of having to do 3 or 4 warm-ups in order to get ready for a competition. But we have, you know, some of the best weather here in California.
Absolutely.
And here in the Central Valley, it's going to be great. And even though it's a little windy and we had a couple sprinkles yesterday, it wouldn't be nationals without a little bit of rain. So got that out of the way.
So you're ready. All right.
Yeah.
Alicia Wagner, good luck to you. Now, again, the NCAA Track and Field Championships are going on all this weekend here at CSUS. So if you get a chance, come out. There are still tickets available. See some of the best athletes compete this weekend, including Alicia Wagner in women's pole vault that we just saw. Guys, back to you.
Yeah, and Mae, a track meet is just so much fun to go to, especially at that level, because there's always something going on around the track.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like going to the circus, and there's always a little sideshow to look at.
It's true.
Absolutely.
What great
good people watching time.
Yeah.